Welcome back.
Hopefully they'll let us know what happened to Brad this time. Because I seriously hope he didn't die. Because he didn't die. He landed on his feet. But all right, let's see.
Did you happen to see Brad down there? My brotherly instincts are going pretty crazy right now.
Sorry, I didn't.
God damn it. Come on, what the hell are you, man?
Well, what the fuck is going on with this ship? Because I gotta be honest, it feels like there's some like evil, like literal evil going on down there.
Let's just stay calm and relatively sane about this, okay?
The stuff I saw, it's like there were these old soldiers, they were bodies, they were dead, but then they came alive and—
That doesn't sound that crazy right about now.
I saw something. This old lady. I mean, she was batshit crazy, like dinosaur old. Not that that's a bad thing, but she just like up and vanished on me.
Alex wasn't the only Alex.
What are you talking about?
There were things walking around with his face on them. Alex's face, it was horrifying.
Julia, I'd never hurt you. You know that, right?
No, I know, it's just—
Let's time out, okay? This place is too fucked up to just be fucked up. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, something is going on here. So what do we know for sure that we can all agree on?
Am I crazy or are we on a ghost ship? Like, ghost ships are real and this is one and we're totally on it and holy shit, we're so totally fucked?
I was gonna say the same thing.
I know we're not the first people to see weird shit here. Apparently the guards were super freaked out by something they saw in the cargo holds.
We found a note that said a bunch of guys tried to get out of guard duty because they were really freaked out by something. What happened to everybody on this ship? Where did they all go?
I feel like we're on Real Houseboats or the River Styx.
So where did all the corpses come from?
They actually look like they've been scared to death.
Did you see the gold? Anything?
Yeah, I'm starting to think that there isn't actually any gold around here.
Okay. That still doesn't explain anything.
What do you think actually happened to this place?
The goddamn mystery box is what it is.
I saw 1947 on the newspaper.
We know more than we did before. That's something at least.
We're wasting time. Whatever we do, we have to do it now.
Time to get off this ship.
We're not going anywhere without the distributor cap. The Duke needs it to run.
Hold on. The ship's gotta have a radio. If we can find it and use it.
That's great, but do you think it still works?
Just need to find a way up there. We gotta get off this damn ship.
Yeah.
I know it sounds crazy, but maybe it was these guns that took down the plane from our dive.
Use these if they weren't Swiss cheesed.
Look at all this damage. You want to repair it?
Find a way up?
Sadly, no, but I'll keep my eyes open.
Check for leaks by tightly squeezing the flexible corrugated hose at the end. The mask should pump more like a face. Bigger squeeze the mask. If the mask does not crumble, there may be a leak. Readjust the mask to ensure it is still in place. The process is up until the mask crumbles to ensure there are no leaks.
Huh. Must have been moving some pretty dangerous cargo.
Hey, a little help over here.
Fall to the right, then don't fall off the ship.
I think this is our way up. Give me a lift.
What? Why is it always... That means like... Why is the girl in the lift?
I'll pull you up.
This is where I chased Gunrad before.
Huh. I thought it looked familiar.
Over here! Got a way through here.
Last log shows him caught in a storm.
Weather continues to deteriorate and does forecast clearing up. Reception was several lightning strikes, hitting OEM causing us sustained damage. I think it's the water, but it's out of control.
Find a radio yet?
No, but there's gotta be a radio on this ship. There has to be. Something's wrong here. If you were headed to San Francisco, you'd be crazy to take this route.
It's almost like they didn't want anyone to know they were coming.
Like hide and seek out in the ocean?
Ship was blown off course, cloud cover was bad. They couldn't establish a position. Take a look. No freaking way. This thing actually still works?
Well, radio science hasn't changed much in 70 years, as long as there's power.
I'll give it a whirl. Ah, it's working.
It's a number station. Military bandit.
Let's ask them for help. Hey! Hey! Is anyone out there hearing this? Hello?
Received. Over.
Holy shit! We got him! If you can hear us, we're on a ship, an old freighter. Our coordinates are approximately 12 degrees 30 minutes south, 151 degrees 20 minutes west. Please, get here now. We need help. We're on a freighter, abandoned, huge, and old. Hello? Hello? Is anyone out there? Please, come in.
Yo, guys, check it out.
This has got to lead somewhere. Maybe we can find a way to get the power back.
We need to get that radio working.
I think someone should wait here in case a message comes through.
I gotta be honest. I don't think I'm gonna make it down there in my shape.
I'll go, obviously.
I'm coming too.
Hey, what? Julia, no.
You're not always gonna be there to protect, big guy. I can handle this. Trust me.
I'm still the captain of something, and the captain's telling you that I'm going too.
All right. You and me, Fliss.
You guys okay down there?
I'm okay.
So, what's next?
I'm gonna find the generator so we can power the radio.
I'll wait up here by the radio.
Hey.
This way.
Looks like we're in the lower levels of the ship.
So it looks like there was some sort of fight and this Charlie went to the brig.
Yep, they did. Private Charles Anderson on leave from duty did display intoxication in a manner not becoming a member of the U.S. Army. Private Anderson was engaging with another soldier in a drunken argument. It is the opinion of the arresting officer that this would lead to a public brawl and steps were taken to ensure that both men would return to the ship.
10-day sentence? Must have been a big fight.
Minutes of meeting between Scientist X, CWO Walter Bishop, CWO Tom Palmer, with Sergeant Peter Wood observing. I think they've been aware of certain agencies investigating the blank chemical and biological agents of warfare. Geneva Protocol and experiments.
Someone named Joe was in the sick bay.
You know your tab is growing by the hour now, huh?
Hourly now? I would have thought we graduated to charge by the minute.
Noted. In your invoice.
Might have been the son of someone on board.
Pops, come back soon. This is the dead body he found inside that.
Wow! Jesus! Calm down during the course of our meeting and test for speech, reaction memory, and decision making all of your normal. Their case of closer. COSR. Take a look. Look, down there. I think that's the engine room.
You're right. Let's go down there. Shit. No more ladder.
I can drop the rest of the way.
Hey! Are you okay?
Yeah, fine. Come on down. See that? Ray, no. Of course you didn't.
See what?
Yeah, I think I'm actually seeing clearly for the first time in a while. None of this shit is happening. Nothing jumped out at me. No weird drowned people. None of the shit that's freaking us all out. I think it's the fog that's causing it.
Yeah, you might be onto something. Maybe that's what happened to the sailors on the ship in the first place?
Yeah, maybe so.
Could this have anything to do with the wrecked plane from the dive?
I don't know. It seems like the plane came in contact with the ship, but it's just a theory.
Wow. Okay, let's keep going.
That was pretty astute of him. He's watched our boys before. So I definitely think that he was paid long. Doesn't mean that stuff can't actually still hurt you. It just means the fog is causing it. Is this where I'm supposed to be going? Yeah, it looks like it. So what's back there?
this, the ship was anchored.
Star Bell acknowledged cut engine power. Order received to anchor in shallow water.
Hey, look at this.
The rebreather.
I bet the fisherman brought it from the Duke.
You think it still works?
It's got maybe a few minutes of air left. Worth taking with us? It's gonna slow us down.
Nah, forget it. It's too heavy to drag along with us.
No. We should take it. Parts of the ship are completely underwater.
Salut! Je sais ce que t'essaies de faire! Tu veux me tuer? Hein? Mais c'est moi qui vais te tuer! Dis-moi seulement où est ce putain d'or! Je t'ai dit de la fermer, sale menteur! Ferme ta gueule de merde! Tu dis n'importe quoi! Tout ce que tu racontes, c'est des conneries! Alors, ferme ta sale gueule de merde! Les esprits morts viennent me chercher. Je vous attends, bande d'enculés.
Stop.
Yeah. I think we might be wise to steer clear of it.
Yeah.
Shit! He's coming!
No shit.
There's no use hiding, you little foot.
What's the problem with sharing all that gold, eh? There must be plenty of that to go around, more than enough. And we're all in this together, right? Trying to cut me out of the deal? You can't have all the gold. And I'm to be left here to die. But I am the captain. I am in control. And I am the one that says who goes and who stays.
He's going to be on us soon. You have any ideas? Just stay out of sight. Let's see what he does.
The smug Americans have smashed their way into a foreign land and come up short. The generators are on. The gold is mine. And now I'm the one who gets to smash. Me! With my big fucking hammer!
How strong do you think this door is?
I was just gonna ask you that.
Okay. Okay. None of you move. None of you go all changing on me now. Turn around. Slow. Real slow. Okay. All right. Not changing. None of that. Raise your hands up. Slow. No, no. Not like that. I said, no changing.
Whoa, 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 listen. Listen to me. We have no fight with you. We all just want to get out of here safely. You understand?
I'm sorry, but if you're breathing, then you don't got much of a choice in the matter. You don't got a say. Not again! It's all gone changing on me!
What? What's changing?
Stay away! Stay back from the mist!
Hey! There's no mist, man!
Don't breathe it! Don't breathe the mist!
Wait, what is this mist? What does it do?
It's... life. Bringing things to life that shouldn't be alive. It's inside now. Inside with us now.
You need to slow down.
Stop! Stop! It's in one of us, isn't it?
Put the gun down now.
Why would you say that? Why are you telling me what to do? Yeah, you breathed in the mist. It's happening. I can feel it.
Okay. Look, there was something in the last room. A fog or a mist, maybe?
I knew it. I told you. Did you breathe it in?
No! No, I mean, we held our breath, man. The mist is not inside of us.
Oh, really? I know you're all fancy divers, but you expect me to buy that? We've been down here for hours. You've been holding your breath this whole time. You're holding your breath right now!
Stop! Just hold on. We have a rebreather from my boat.
What?
Yes, we've been using it to get the mist out of us, you understand? We could use it on you too.
No, 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 no! You keep that thing away from me! Oh, good. It's in me. I got the mist in me, don't I? It's in me, isn't it? I can feel it swirling around in there. It's changing me. On the inside.
No, man. There's no mist inside you. I can tell.
Stop. Stop lying. You can all see it in me, can't you? You're all just lying. And the mist is inside.
Could have saved Junior, maybe? Oh, well.
Oh, dear God.
Dude can run with that sledgehammer out here.
Fantastic. This just keeps getting better and better. It's a dead end. We have to go back.
You have to re-breathe it.
I am not fucking drowning today. No way.
There's 472 rivets in this room, which can only mean one thing. I've been in here way too long. Hey! Is anyone hurt down there? Shit. I gotta go after him, don't I? We gotta go make sure everyone's okay.
Jesus, did something go wrong?
You're gonna stay here with the radio. I'll go after them.
Seriously, Connie? You're not gonna be able to talk your way around a maniac with a gun.
I'm a big boy. This is my mess, and I'll clean it up.
Watch yourself down there. I'll make the call as soon as the radio comes back on, so you better hurry the fuck back.
That leads to what you call it. I know where that goes. From the beginning of the game. boy killed his friend. I told him not to shoot the little boy. And the little boy stabbed him. At a place like this. The scale of our search and recovery missions across the area have yielded results far greater than expected. Unfortunately, there is now a shortage of dope caskets. We locate the remains of any missing persons at the water purification plant. Smaller caskets. I guess it'll have to be Hawkins for a bastard, because there was nothing left of him. I know this isn't ideal, guys, but they'll give him a proper funeral and respect his service once we got his body back. We just have to make this work for now. Also, he's the one in the small, little bitty casket.
How big is this place?
That's the best solution here. Not yet.
Game freezing took me all out of my element. I was thinking I was gonna have to press the PS button and restart the game and everything. Then all of a sudden it came back. Hell no. I think he's just dead. I think it saved right that right that happened. And we don't have a distributor cap.
Call a close shave. Okay. So, anybody got any other ideas?
Froze, all of a sudden she pulling the lever, like, whatever.
Hello?
Jump down that thing. Ran onto the edge.
Let me see. Duke of Milan? No engine. Guess that's pretty much the end of it.
Best I can figure out. We got a couple days. Maybe more if we can collect some rainwater.
You know, I was hoping to die with a little more style.
Hey, what is that?
Hey!
Got a visual. Several civilians on board. I can confirm that the target is a converted military cruiser as described. Jesus, it's just a bunch of kids.
I saw Alex, and it wasn't Alex, it was someone else. But they looked just like Alex, and he was sneering at me. And the way he looked at me, laughing. He wanted to hurt me.
I guess you could say I lived my greatest nightmare. I was relentlessly stalked by a beautiful woman, and all I wanted to do was run the hell away.
There was this man down there, this weird fucking hooded guy, and I was scared and he was going to attack me, so I had a knife.
He was my little bro. God, he was just a kid. He was just a kid.
Can I see him, please? I just need to see him.
I mean, hey, I'm no prude. A lady's down, then who might be picky, but this one. Up close, she was, she's not exactly getting the motor running, you know what I mean? You might even say she could melt the rubber off your tires. And not in a good way.
It was dark. It was me or him, so I thought that... Look, I did what I had to do.
I was supposed to look out for him, you know? But he was the smart one. He was the one who always knew what was up. And I was supposed to look out for him.
I also don't understand how he died. I have to go back and play from that part or something. There's something that, like, the period where he jumped down.
That's it. Game over. You're done. For now, at least. You could always try again, see if you can't do better next time around. Impressive. Almost everyone survived. Almost. I suppose when the curtain falls, you're either ready for it or you're not. And the distributor cap? Boom. Unfortunate. It's all about decisions, isn't it? Decisions made in a hurry, in a panic, made with the heart instead of the head, or vice versa. Sometimes those decisions take a long time to have repercussions. But there are repercussions. There are always repercussions. Till we meet again. Maybe in Little Hope, maybe somewhere else. But be certain, we will meet again. It's inevitable.
We meet again, maybe in Little Hope, maybe somewhere else. And Little Hope is the second.
Won't you spare me over till another year? 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 Won't you spare me over till another year?
Saw someone in the woods.
Whoever it was, they're gone.
Okay, very good. Who's there?
I fashioned her with my own hand.
Appreciate y'all sticking around for this video for the ending of Man of Medan. Leave a comment. Like if you enjoyed the video. Check out my other videos if you have any time. I'll catch you all.